when the play's down, try not to get my head. I try and stand up. Or just maybe move the camera off. I noticed yesterday the guy was asleep at the camera a little bit because it's stuck right in the middle.
Thank you. Thank you. Two College Cougars have one more game, and that will be the end of the 23-24 regular season. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Sioux College Cougars Hockey. My name is Mike Armitage, and I'll be play-by-play for today's game between the Sioux College Cougars and the visiting Davenport Panthers. Let's go down to the ice level for both the American and Canadian national anthems. Thank you. The Davenport Panthers will start with the line of Arian Sterin, Nathan Hartline, and the number 28, Ryan Long. On defense, Matthew Lichick. And number 21, Luke Nicholas. Starting in goal for the Panthers is number 35, Austin Bartel. Sioux College Cougars will start their final home game of the season with the line of Bly, Taguna, and Chaffee. On defense, Jordan Ritchie. And hometown product number 13, Mateo Perry. And starting in goal for the Sioux College Cougars will be number 31, Zach Tarantini. Davenport in black, Sioux College in white. As we get ready for the finale of the 23-24 season here at the beautiful Northern Community Center in Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. And the puck comes, squirts out, and that's Ritchie getting it deep inside the Davenport zone on the far side. That's Hartline, getting up the boards. They decided to reverse the puck, and that's Sterin, the team captain of the Panthers, up the boards, and it's flipped high in the air just to the right of Tarantini. On the far side, Mateo Perry, high in the air and out, and that's hopped by Nathan Hartline all the way down the ice, and that'll be Luke Nicholas handing it off to Matthew Lichick. Lichick, he was hit there by Windsor. And the puck is on the stick of Finitari, waiting across the ice. And that's Ritchie, just wants to dump that in, and he needs a change, and off he goes. Davenport gathering the puck in, dropping that off. And that's Lichick on the near boards. Jocks with a shot, and he fired that one high over top of the goal. And the puck's dumped out into the neutral zone area. Jackson Jock across the far side. And that's Chase Johnson. Jock fell! Oh, a nice play there to recover as he blew a tire. And the puck is dumped right in onto the Davenport goalie, and he steers it aside. Schneider bounces it off the boards. Whoop, gets it out into the neutral zone, and that's Crowder, big Cole Crowder, knocked down by Windsor to Finitari over the line. Finitari battling for the puck in the corner. In comes Windsor for a loose puck. Windsor had it, but it went through his legs. And Olenek. And it's out into the neutral zone. Crowder bounces that off the boards. Finitari fell. Back comes Zach Schneider over the line, down the left side. Shoots it. He shot that one away wide. Chaffee has the puck for Sioux College. Coming down the line, Ethan Esposito. What a nice move there by Esposito, the team's leading scorer. And he just gave that away. And the break. And that's Hartline. Right in, oh, and he lost control of the puck as he went right to left on Tarantini. A first good scoring chance of the game. Another shot right on, rebound! And Tarantini finds it before any team player in the block could pounce on the rebound. Two glorious chances there for Davenport with 17:37 left to go in period number one. Still no score. Will Healy on the draw for Davenport, and he wins that cleanly. Shoots, that was a shot, was blocked somewhere in front of the goal. And that's John Taguna on the right side. That's Caleb Wood, and he just tossed that into the corner. Taguna on the puck quickly. In behind the Davenport goal, Taguna and Gamber looking for a loose puck. The puck comes out and Gamber has it on the right side. Outlet pass through the center, Brian Wolfe. Hit there by Bly. And a nice play by Bly to stop that. Santa Maria through the neutral zone, dumping that in. And Bartel shoots it away. Bly shoots, that was wide. Hartline down the right side. Over the line, Hartline. He was double teamed there by Perry and Wood and stopped in his tracks. Novello fell down. That's about three players that fell down right by the blue line. Perry hands that off to Wood. Bounces that off the boards. Here comes LaValle. Down the right side, one-on-one. LaValle. LaValle going to the net. Shoots a right pad save there by Bartel. Another shot, and that was steered aside by the Panthers goalie. LaValle in behind the Davenport goal, trying to come out in front of the goal, but he was poke-checked by Nicholas. Oldham. Nice move by Oldham to hang on to the puck. Russ Oldham shoots that one off a leg and went wide of the goal. Back comes Davenport. Hartline, and he chopped it in. And he needs a change as he's tired. Windsor coming down the right side. Off the stick of LaValle. And it's fired back in by Zach Schneider. Richie in behind the net. Leaves it there for Oldham. Oldham pushes that to Richie. To LaValle on the right boards as Richie was hit hard. Back comes Novello. Ethan Novello, he was checked at the line and it's picked up by Gable Enzik. And it's shot inside the Sioux College zone. Windsor gently off the boards. Shot there! Right on, and Tarantini with a left pad save. Back comes Sioux College, 3-on-1. Windsor shoots and he shot it wide of the goal. 15 minutes left to go in period number one. Still no score here at the Northern Community Center. Crowder leaves it there for Timbari. For Zimbari. And that's Chase Johnson up the center to Finitary. And he let it go. And that's Luke Nicholas giving it there to Nico Ryman. And he dumped it in. Short side shot. Tarantini was there. Crowder coming out with the puck. And that's Zimbari. That pass was behind Wood. Sorry, that was Windsor, not Wood. Crowder looking for Esposito coming in. But that pass was intercepted by Brian Wolk. And out of reach of Esposito, and it comes out into the neutral zone. Esposito lost control of that one. And that went off the stick of Race Jacobs. Chaffee all the way across to Esposito. And he bounced that one off the boards. And Jameis was jumped. Chaffee with a shot! Score! No! It's in the glove of Bartel. What a save that was. And from this angle, it looked like he had an open net. But Austin Bartel with a huge glove save with 13:52 left to go in period number one. Save of the game already, maybe, and it's only 6 minutes gone in the first period. Esposito, nice move there. Told you, but he lost control of the puck. Back to the Panthers. Over the line, Esposito doing a good job in coming back and taking the puck from Sterin. Chaffee, who was just robbed by Bartel, looking for another chance. Chaffee, for a goal! Rebound, the pass coming for the goal, and Perry couldn't find it. And it's knocked out into the neutral zone. Braden Bartlett over the line. And that went off Jameis' skate. For the goal, there's nobody there. And Esposito picks it up on the left wing. Out comes big number nine. Batted out of the air by the Panthers defender. And here comes Ryan Gamber over the line. Checked nicely by Brandon Kipling. Chaffee dumped that down the ice. Esposito's going to be there first, so no icing. But Esposito's 1-on-4. With Bly coming in. Bly has the puck for Sioux College. Leaves it there for Esposito. Nice move. Another nice move. Right to left. Shoots. And he whistled that one wide. Back to the point. And that's Jock across to Bly. Shoots. Banks that one off the boards. And that's Santa Maria that has the puck on the right side. Decides to shoot it back inside the zone. And that was intercepted by Sterin. And the puck is on the stick of Gable Enzik. Out through the center, that's Ryan Long. Trying to get around Jock. Long and Jock, nice play by Jock. And the puck is on the far side by the Sioux College bench, kept in by Enzik. Why? Handing it off to Wood. And here comes Santa Maria. And that's Taguna. Taguna right to left. Keeps waiting, and he shot it off the side of the goal. It comes out in front of the goal, and there was nobody there but black jerseys. Jackson Jock will come back for the puck for Sioux College. In front of his own goal, and batted away there by Jordan Ritchie. Out comes Caleb Wood over line. He swung and a miss on that one. Backhand pass. And that couldn't get by three Panther defenders. Johnson. And that's just jumped back inside the Panther zone. And Bartlett leaves it there for Schneider. Nicholas on the far side. And it's going to come back on the stick of Zach Schneider. Long pass. Looking for Race Jacobs. But that one off the stick of Ethan Novello. Oldham trying to get out of his own zone. LaValle, he was checked in the center ice area. LaValle overskated the puck. Back comes Wolk, and he shot that one, went off Johnson's leg. Johnson bodied his man, Wolk off the puck. That's Lichick. Lichick, that's it going, that one off. LaValle, wide of the goal. To College, flips it high and out, and that relieves the pressure. LaValle has the puck for Sioux College. Around to the left, shoots, right on. And Bartel was there again with 10:38 to go in period number one. We're still tied at zeros. On a beautiful hockey afternoon in Sault Ste. Marie. Temperature just about the freezing mark. Perfect, not too hot, not too cold. Face off to the right of Austin Bartel. Sioux College winning that draw, but they couldn't keep it in. Crowder. And trying to get Mateo Perry, but that was behind him. A good work by Perry. Back comes Sioux College. Windsor. Down the right side in front of the net. And that pass was behind everybody. And swept away by Ryan Long up into the Panthers bench. And the whistle goes. 10 minutes and he got a good play. Oh, and there was a Malachi crunch there by Windsor and Perry on Ryan Long. Cole Crowder pushes it up ahead. That's intercepted. And back come the Panthers. That's Hartline. He shot it wide. It comes out in front of the goal. Scores! Arian Sterry opens the scoring for the Davenport Panthers. And with 9:36 to go in the first period, it's 1-0 for Davenport. Hartline with the initial shot that went wide of the goal. And Arian Sterin was right there to put it in the empty cage. And it's 1-0 for Davenport. Healy winning that draw for Davenport. And that's Ryan Gamber coming down the left side. He fell. Another shot. And that one went wide of the goal. That was by Healy. Healy has the puck. Back to the point. For the goal. And that was... Puck went off the end of the stick of Grace Jacobs. Oh, no, red pass. We got a breakaway for Ethan Esposito. Shoot, scores! Holy cow, what a pass that was. All the way from the goal line. On a streaking Ethan Esposito at the Davenport blue line. And he ripped that right along the ice and beat Panthers goaltender Austin Bartel. And we've got ourselves a tie with 9 minutes and 11 seconds left to go in period number one. We're tied at one. Beautiful goal by Esposito. What a talent this young man is. Why? Leaving it there for Kipling. And that's Wood up to Takuna. Takuna was knocked off the puck. Back comes Hartline. Owen, he sidestepped the check there from Kipling. Santa Maria over the line, and he just dumped it inside, deep inside the Panthers zone. Wood come in and stole the puck, and it's back to Kipling. Shoots, and he shot that one wide. Wood shot that one wide. Kipling's going to shoot it towards the net, and instead of a deflection, that one was stopped by Taguna. Back come the Panthers. That could be icing. As Zach Schneider shot the puck from his own side of the red line. And with 8:23 left to go in period number one, we're tied at one. Off the draw, Jock. Across the far side. Esposito back to Jock. Jock decides to dump it a deep in behind the goal. And it ends up on the far side. And Hartline will just dump it out. And Jace Jackson Jocks gives it there. Shot there by Jameis. And that was a blocker save by Bartel. Luke Nicklaus spinning away, but checked by Chaffee. Jameis has it. Jameis into Chaffee. And he didn't see that pass as it went behind the skates. Jameis has the puck again. And back comes Davenport, 2-on-1. That's Jacobs, but he's run off by Jock. Goal, goal, and it's just trickled to the right of Tarantini. That pass stopped at the line. Shot, that was blocked, right in. And Zach Tarantini hops on the puck with 7:29 left to go in period number one. We're all tied up at one. And off the draw, that's Richie, has the puck. Up to LaValle, LaValle cutting to the center, but the puck, they've got two colleges offside, so they have to all vacate the zone, and Davenport will have a chance to come out. That pass was off the mark. And Windsor, Jordan Richie, up to LaValle. LaValle shoots, and he shot that one wide. LaValle couldn't gather that one in. Back comes Zach Snyder down the right side on Mateo Perry. Shoots, and he shot that one, but Perry got a stick on that one. Novello lost that puck in his own zone, but Oldham come back to pick it up, and the officials are saying that Jordan Richie loved the puck ahead to Russ Oldham, and that means the whistle goes. 6:44 left to go in period number one. Sioux College won, and the Davenport Panthers won. Healy winning that draw. Shot right on, rebound, there isn't any. And that was a quick shot by Ian Milton. Right off the draw, and Tarantini was sharp with 6:41 left to go in period number one. Well, tied up at one. And this time Sioux College wins the draw. Vinatieri on the near boards. And Blay, Bly comes, brings it back to Crowder. Crowder, oh, he shot that one off the back of his own net. And it's out into the neutral zone area. Milton. And it ends up on the stick of Crowder. And he gives it to Zimbaro. And they're saying another glove hand pass. And they're saying that Troy, that Cole Crowder handed it off to Gabriel Zimbaro. And the faceoff will come outside the Sioux College zone. 6:22 left to go in period number one. Well, tied at one. Windsor winning that draw, back to Crowder, lost it, backhand shot, and that was backhanded just wide of the goal, that was Hartline. Milton coming in, Sterren decides to backhand it to an open corner, and Crowder trying to get it up to Zimbaro. Zimbaro couldn't get it out, and there was a huge collision, two Cougars and a Panther. Animals are wild out there, two Panthers and a Cougar went down. Crowder slowing things up. Vinatieri on the right wing, but he didn't handle that pass as it bounced off his stick. Nathan Hartline trying to pass it to himself. Windsor guarding in the way, and he was hit by Hartline. Hartline, good sized lad. Hartline and Novello exchanging good afternoons here in Sault Ste. Marie. Matthew Litchick. His brother Matthew not available for today's game, but it's on the stick of Nicklaus, and he shot, and he, that was blocked. Long. Another shot right on off Tarantini. Crowder. Up the far boards, Esposito just let it go out. Litchick on the far side to Nicklaus. Back to Litchick. Back to Nicklaus. Out through the center, and that was just out of reach of number 28, Ryan Long. Crowder. On the far side, Esposito couldn't reach it. Will Healy lost that one to Chaffee. And that's Luke Nicklaus dumping it in. And it's on the stick of Cole Crowder. Big number 27 for Sioux College. Setting it up behind his own goal to Chaffee. Bounces that off the boards. And it's bounced back in by Gamber. Jackson Jock will try again for Sioux College. Jock skating out himself. Down the right side. And he shot it all the way down. And Bartel will leave it there. And it's on the stick of Gambler. Gambler fires it on the far side. Esposito let it go. Kipling kept it in with a good play. Esposito has the puck for Sioux College. Ethan Esposito shoots right on. And Bartel was right there as Esposito has one goal already for the Cougars. Looking for number two. 4 minutes to go in period number one. We're all tied up at one. Santa Maria winning that draw. That was a shot by Kipling, but he didn't get much of that one. Taguna went behind the goal. Wood back to Kipling. Back to Wood. Wood, he was poke checked. Back comes the Panthers. On the far side, that's dumped in by Wolf. Kipling being there first. Kipling on the stick of Taguna. Back comes Santa Maria. Oh, and that pass was Wood. And he was on a break, but the pass was behind him. And a little bit of a late shot there by Wood as the whistle went on the offside. And a little bit of a gathering, but nothing comes of that one. 3:31 left to go in period number one. Sioux College won. And the Davenport Panthers won. Santa Maria. And Starin on the draw. Starin winning that draw. And it's on the stick of Ryan Long. Hammered on a gorgeous open ice hit by Jackson Jock. Kipling back to Jock. On the stick of Taguna. And it back comes Ryan Long. Long dumping it in. And Tarantini will leave it there for Jock. Jock high off the glass and out. Wood trying to steal it from his player. Zimbaro for the Sioux College Cougars on the right boards. Back to Wood. It fell a goal and Santa Maria was looking around but couldn't find the puck. Wood throwing out looking for Santa Maria coming in, but that was picked off by Stern and he leaves it there for Lychik. Long pass and that's knocked down by Ritchie. And then batted inside the Sioux College zone by Ryan Long. Chase Johnson coming out for Sioux College. Nice move right to left there. Beautiful. Shoots. Johnson with a rebound. In front of the goal. And Starin picks it up. And back come the Panthers. That's Jacobs over the line. For the goal. And there's nobody there. Oldham leaves it there. And he has it again. Oldham. He was checked. Right at the line by Zach Snyder. Snyder shoots in front of the goal. Then a good play by Chase Johnson to tie up the stick of the Panthers player. He would have had an open cage. Johnson flipping it high out. And there's a chase. LaValle chasing Snyder. And Snyder decides to stop and get it out into the neutral zone. That's Olenczuk. Olenczuk shoots. It's a low hard shot in front of the goal and Tarantini knocked that away. Schneider at the line. He just fired it to an open corner. And Sioux College will get out. Oh, Novello. Two on two. Finitari catching up. Novello in front of the net and Finitari couldn't bat it out of the air. Back comes Davenport. Three on three. Over the line. Backhand pass. And that's on the stick of Healy, but he let it go out into the neutral zone. Lychik checked by Windsor. Windsor shoots, and that went off the leg of Matthew Lychik. Perry with a shot, that went wide. Zimbaro stops. Zimbaro back to Bly. Zimbaro, good work by Zimbaro. Windsor back pass. Vinatieri with a shot right on blocker save. And back comes Brian Wolk for Davenport. And he flips it in. And there's a little bit of a hit there by Bly. Referees let that one go back a little bit late. Back comes Sioux College. Vinatieri on the right side. That puck bounced off the stick, but he has it again down the right side. Leaves it there. But that went behind. The player in Jackson Jocks kept it in. Vinatieri, the far side. Jocks keeping it in. Backhand shot. And that was blocked over top of the glass as the buzzer goes. And the first period is over. 20 minutes in the books. Here in Sault Ste. Marie, the Sioux College Cougars won, and the Davenport Panthers won. We'll be back in about 13 minutes time for period number two. scoring summary for the first period. There was two goals. The captain of the Davenport Panthers, Arian Starrett, opened the scoring and made it 1-0 for Davenport. And then right away on a long lead pass, Ethan Esposito on a breakaway. Tied the game at 1, and that's where we stand now as we get ready for the second period. We're all tied up at 1. As we get ready for the second period, here we go. Arian Starrett and Jameis on the draw. And the puck comes quickly back inside the Sioux College zone. Ritchie decides to keep it himself. Jordan Ritchie on the far side. And that's Jackson Jock dumping it in. Jameis quickly on the puck in the corner and behind the Panthers goal line. Jameis. Esposito lurking around in front of the goal looking for a pass. And Hartline couldn't get out. Hard shot there by Ritchie. And that was right on. And Bartel with the save. 19:31 left to go in period number 2. The Sioux College Cougars and the Davenport Panthers are tied at 1. Jameis and Bartlett on the draw. Bartlett winning it for the Panthers. Kept in by Jock. Jock, nice move. There, another one. By the net, and the puck didn't make it through. Chaffee back to Jameis. Cross to the far side. One-time shot by Ritchie. And a good save by Bartel. Esposito overskated that one. And that ends up on the stick of Ryan Gamber. Gamber all the way across. And the pass couldn't find the stick of the winger on the far side. Race Jacobs shooting it, and Tarantini will drop it there for number 6, Jordan Ritchie. Ritchie looking for Esposito, but he decides to go across, and the pass didn't make it, and the puck comes right back inside the Sioux College zone, and Tarantini decides not to take any chances and jumps on the puck. 18:46 to go in period number 2. We're all tied up at 1. Santa Maria winning that draw. Back to Johnson, and that puck comes all the way down, but there's no icing as it went through the legs of Zach Snyder. Gamber stopped in his tracks by Wood. And Ryan Wolk off the boards. And now, but Perry stops out. He'll fire that one right back in. And Gamber has the puck for the Panthers. Far side, Ryan Long, but he didn't handle that pass very well. But it's batted back in by Santa Maria, so there's no offside. Oh, there is offside. That was probably not the right call because the Sioux College Cougars knocked it in. Perry, that bounced off his stick. Snyder, oh, long outlet pass for Ryan Long, and he missed it. But Long has the puck. Still has the puck, but it comes back outside into the neutral zone. Close to too many players on the ice, but back comes Taguna. Taguna, by the net! And Wood took a shot at that one, but he didn't get all of it. Oldham coming in, looking for a loose puck. Wood also has a stick in there with about 8 skates, and it squirts out. Caleb Wood, wrap around the front of the net, and that couldn't find the bellow. Wood trying to come out, now swatted away. Panthers fire around the boards, and why? That pass was headed for Oldham, and that's going to be offside. As Brian Wolk was trapped inside the zone when the puck crossed the line. 17:07 left to go in period number 2. Davenport and Sioux College all tied up at 1. Starrett and Oldham. Starrett winning that draw. Back to Litchick. Nicholas. Hartline. He's had a good game for Davenport so far, and they could have called that one offside too, maybe. And it's dumped high over top of the glass. And out of play by Nathan Hartline. So the play will come back outside the Sioux College blue line. 16:53 left to go in period number two. Sioux College 1 and Davenport 1. And holding by that draw. That's LaValle. Lost it there. Hartline fires it in. On the far side, that's Bly. On the stick of number 21, that's Novello. Oldham coming in with a shot, and that was steered aside by Bartel. Oldham getting tangled up with the official. In front of the net, and that went off a skate. Back comes Hartline down the right side, cutting through center, and he was bucked there by Crowder. Nicholas let that go by Windsor on the far side, and that's Novello. Shoots, and that one didn't make it through. Novello, he was checked in behind the goal. Baronet, and there came Windsor. Shoots! That was Novello with a shot, and that one went wide. Kipling being bothered there by Hartline. Windsor coming in to take it, and Kipling will have to come back and retreat and start again. Zimbaro for Sioux College to Crowder. Coming through center, he shot it in. Vinatieri on the stick of Windsor. In front of the net, and there was no Sioux College players there. Windsor back to Kipling. Kipling shoots, that one was blocked in front of the goal. Windsor to Vinatieri. Vinatieri to Zimbaro. In front of the net, that didn't make it. And that's Sterren, decides to go the other way. Jacobs couldn't get it out, and it's shot back. It comes in front of the goal, and Windsor was there, but the puck didn't hit a stick. Kipling shoots it towards the goal, and that was a right pad save by Bartel. Zimbaro lost that to Long. Zimbaro has it back, and puck's bouncing around. Zimbaro just decides to shoot it in behind the goal. Windsor lets it go by. Vinatieri back to the point. Jock shoots, that one went off the stick and behind the goal. Zimbaro back to Jacques. One time shot. Rebound! And Windsor couldn't reach it. And the puck comes all the way around the near boards. Kipling, nice play to keep it in. Shoots, that one went wide of the goal. Jackson Jocks keeping it in. Across to Kipling. Kipling. And that went off the stick of Zimbaro. And Zach Schneider will slow things down. Long pass. And that went by everybody. And no icing on the play. Jackson Jock back to get it. Long outlet pass. That's not going to make it anywhere close to Esposito. Kipling. Right in. Oh, rebound. And that was number 8, Braden Bartlett, who got a break on a misplay by the Sioux College Cougars. And Tarantini bailed him out. And the score remains at 1. Back comes Braden Bartlett. 3-on-2. Shoots a quick shot there. And Zach Tarantini with a nice glove save. With 13:40 left to go in period number two. Sioux College 1. And Davenport no score. Jamison Healy. And Jamis waiting that shot. Perry high off the glass. On the stick of Chaffee to Esposito. Esposito shoots and he shot that one low and wide. Zimbaro went off the skate of Zimbaro. Back comes Davenport. That's Healy. Out in front. And that was intercepted. And Ritchie. Oh, and Esposito anticipated the puck coming the other way. Gamber for Davenport on the far side. And that's Healy. Healy! Oh, and Ritchie stepped into him. And Ritchie is going to get a penalty for tripping on the play, and that certainly didn't look like a trip from our angle here up in the broadcast area. Nonetheless, doesn't matter what we think, referee called it tripping, and the first penalty of the game goes to Sioux College. Davenport will go to the power play with 13:04 left to go in period number two. Well, tied up at 1. Davenport looking to go ahead early in the second period. Healy, Bartlett, and Hartline up front. Nicholas has the puck to Hartline. Back to Nicholas. Nicholas across to Sterin. Back to Sterin. To Bartlett. Bartlett picked up. Chris Tarantini coming out. And he made a nice save on a shot on the far side. And that was by Nicholas. Martel gives it to Sterin. Arian Sterin, the captain of the Davenport Panthers. Slowly coming out of his own end. He drops it off there for Nicholas. Nicholas coming through center. On the near boards for Bartlett. Bartlett stops. Back to Sterin. Back to Bartlett. Bartlett's going to come in. Shoots! And that one off the leg of Johnson. And Zimbardo couldn't get it out. So Crowder has to come back and rip it around the boards. Sterin's going to keep that in. Sterin in front of the net and a deflection in front of the goal by Nicholas. And he deflected it off the crossbar. What a beautiful pass that was by Sterin. And Nicholas couldn't convert. Right on Tarantini with a right pad save, and he decides to stop play and hold on. 11:46 left to go in period number two. 42 seconds left in the penalty to Jordan Ritchie. We're all tied up at one here on Super Bowl Sunday in Sault Ste. Marie. Lenzek lost that draw, and Perry chops it down the ice. Zach Schneider will be back for the Davenport Panthers. Schneider coming through center, over the line. Schneider gathering speed around Jock, and he still has it. Bothered there by Mateo Perry, and a nice play by Perry to cut him off. The puck's kept in by Milton. Milton has the puck, but he let it go back to the point. Milton. And Hartline missed the pass. The puck's kept in. Oh, and there was a pass for Chaffee, but he was just too far in front of him. He was all by himself. Shot from the short side. And that was by Taguna. Nice, good penalty killer Taguna is. And the penalty's over. Sioux College back to full strength. Good penalty killing by the Cougars. And the Panthers are 0 for 1 on the power play. Mateo Perry in his own zone, stopping, regrouping in behind Zach Tarantini. Perry to Taguna. Taguna whiffed on that shot. And Jacob shot it back in. Santa Maria to Wood, over the line. Caleb Wood, the captain of the Sioux College Cougars. Santa Maria coming in looking for a loose puck. Sterin trying to get out. Good work by Wood to keep the puck in. Santa Maria shoots! And a try to toe drag and a quick shot. And Bartels had nothing to do with that one. And he stopped the puck. 10:09 left to go in period number two. Sioux College 1, Davenport 1. Sterin and Oldham on the faceoff. And Sterin, solid on the draw for Davenport. Ryan Kipling has the puck for Sioux College. And that's batted out by LaValle. And it's shot right back in. And Bly will come back and has the puck for Sioux College. Bly decides to stop and regroup. Up the far side, LaValle, that was out of his reach. And that could be icing. And that will be icing on the Sioux College Cougars. 9:40 left to go in period number two. Sioux College won, and the Davenport Panthers won. Davenport winning that draw. Shot down, and that was wide of the goal. A little bit of a collision on the near boards, and the puck's bounced out. LaValle hot on the tail of Schneider. Schneider stops and relieves the pressure. On the far side, that's Will Healy being bothered by number 21, and that's Novello. Novello was knocked down, and there was a high, hard hit, and the puck was nowhere around. There's going to be a penalty call, And this one's going to Davenport. And for the first time in today's game, the Sioux College Cougars will go to the power play. And I didn't even catch what the call was. But it was a high, hard hit. And let's see what the call will be. Will it be 2, 4, or 5 in a game? Zach Snyder will get the gate. And it's 2 minutes. He'll sit in the box for 2 minutes. They'll probably call that roughing. 9:14 left to go in period number two. Jameis Chaffee. And Windsor up front. Back to Esposito. To Jock. Esposito on the far side. That's Jameis. Back to Jock. Jameis on the far side. Nick Jameis, the local product. Back to Jock. Jameis. Coming in. Jameis decides to stop in the far corner. Back to Jock. To Ethan Esposito. Jock. Esposito has the goal for Sioux College. Esposito decides to turn. And he just back for Windsor. Chaffee coming in to pick up the puck, but he couldn't get it. Cubs squirts out in front of the goal, and Bartlett knocked it away. Good work by Nathan Hartlines and shoot the puck down the ice and relieve the pressure. Tarantini passes it off the side to Esposito. Esposito gives it back to Jackson Jock. And here comes Jackson Jock, number 4 for Sioux College. Over the line. Leaves it there for Esposito on the far side for Jameis. Jameis. Right in front of the goal. Oh, and he went from right to left, but he couldn't find the net. Jock. Back to Esposito. Shoots. And now, what a save that was. As that was a shot by Ethan Esposito. Heading right for the open corner. But the glove of Austin Bartel was there in time. 42 seconds left to go in the Sioux College power play. 7:56 left to go in period number two. Second unit for Sioux College is on the ice. Oldham on the draw for Sioux College. And he did win that one. And that's Gamber firing it around the boards. That's going to be kept in by Santa Maria. Santa Maria in front of the net. Quick shot, scores! Ethan Novello with a quick shot. And it's 2-1 for Sioux College. Ethan Novello with a quick shot on a nice pass from Brock Santa Maria. And it's 2-1 for Sioux College. 7:46 left to go on period number two. Wood in front of it. And that was failed to negotiate contact with that one. Back to Johnson. To Crowder. Quick shot. That was blocked in front of the goal. And Santa Maria coming in to body his man. Crowder giving it off to Santa Maria. And the puck's on the far side. Johnson to Caleb Wood. Has to come back out into the neutral zone. Caleb Wood coming through center. And that's Santa Maria dumping it in. Snyder hit hard there by number 19. Caleb Wood, the captain of the Cougars. And Davenport, that's Brian Wolk on the far side. That was a bad pass in behind the player on the far side. And that could be icing if it's not on goal. And that will be icing as Johnson comes back to get the puck. As the referee's over by the Davenport bench. And you cannot change players if you ice the puck at the ACHA level. 6:44 left to go in period number two. Oldham, Bartlett on the draw. Oldham winning that draw. Back to Perry. Mateo Perry in the far corner. Moves it over there. And it comes back to Richie. Falls. But he gets up and he gets it away. And long on the near boards. Intercepted by LaValle. And it's chipped in by Ethan Novello. And long. That was dumped by Novello, and they let that go. And that was more of a penalty than the other one. Hold him in front of the net, and that was bad at the side. Gabe Lenzik trying to get it out, but Perry kept it in. Oldham. Nice. Oldham trying to keep it in. It does. Lavalle with a shot. And that was stopped by Bartel. Lavalle. Hard on the puck. Lavalle. Trying to cut in front of that. And that was batted out of the way by Bartel. Mateo Perry keeping it in. And Oldham has the puck in behind the goal. And he was checked. But here comes Finitari back to Ritchie. Across to Perry. One-time shot. That was blocked. Oldham. Back to Perry. Another shot. Perry shoots. That one was way high over top of the goal. Ritchie. Into Zimbaro. Zimbaro lost that one, but Ritchie kept it in. Good work. And Nicholas finally gets it out. And there could be a break. And that's Wolf. Right in. And Tarantini was there. In time. Back comes Zimbaro. And Windsor. Zimbaro has the puck. To Windsor, and he was taken down in front of the goal. And that was a bit of interference there because the puck wasn't there yet, and he was taken down. End-to-end action. Awesome stuff here in period number two. 5 minutes left to go in period number two. Sioux College 2 and the Davenport Panthers 1. Off the draw. Jocks heaping it in. Oh, and a one-off escape. Back comes Sterin, the captain. Arian Sterin has the goal. Shoots, and that one was deflected wide of the goal. Vichik shot that one wide of the goal. Sterin. Sidestep to check. And Jocks come flying in, but he was knocked down. The puck comes out to the point. Vichik shoots, and that one off Tarantini, high over top of the net. That's going to be kept in by Long. That puck was stopped by Windsor. Ryan Long trying again. Down the left side. Oh, and there's a trip. As Windsor came out and tried to knock the legs out of Ryan Long. And that's not the type of penalty that the coaching staff of the Sioux College team want to see. As he was 100 feet from his net. Not much of a threat to score. Bly's going to the net, to the penalty box. But Bly wasn't the one who tripped him. It was Windsor that tripped him. We'll have to watch the video for that one after the game. But that certainly looked like it was Dylan Windsor that tripped him. Nonetheless, Bly's in the box. And the Davenport Panthers will go back to the power play with 4:16 to go in period number two. Hartline, Healy, and Bartlett up front. Davenport winning the draw, but they couldn't keep it in. And Chaffee is going to cause a little bit of difficulty in the Davenport zone. Back comes Nicholas. Over the line, chased by Chaffee. Nicholas drops it off to Healy, and Crowder fires it hard off the glass and out and all the way down the ice, and Bartel will set it up there for Nathan Hartline. Hartline decides to come out himself. Pass on the far side, deflected in by Healy, and that's going to come out. Rock Brandon Kipling shot that one out into the neutral zone, and the whistle goes. 3.5 minutes left to go in period number two. 1:15 left to go to the penalty of Keyston Bly. Sioux College 2 and the Davenport Panthers 1. Caleb Wood winning that draw back to Crowder, and Crowder's just going to take his time, killing valuable seconds before he rips it down the ice. Right on! And Bartel had to be sharp there. Ryan Wolf let that one go by. Kipling fired it in. Wood trying to spin around it, but he forgot the puck. Nathan Hartline in behind his own goal. Check by Wood. And the puck's going to come out to Crowder. And Crowder will kill off some more viable seconds. Novello, and that puck went off the end of his stick. Back comes Davenport. That's Ian Milton being bodied off the puck there by Crowder. And Crowder had enough on that one to get it by Zach Snyder. And all the way back, Zach Snyder out chasing. Came aboard for this one. Snyder around Crowder. Snyder tried a side shot and it went through everybody. Caleb Wood thought he had a break, but he was checked. And that's Lenzuk. Shot deflected in front of the goal by Ryan Long, but he deflected it wide of the goal. That was a good chance. And the penalty's over. Sioux College back to full strength. Score! Zach Snyder with a high, hard shot from the point. And it's all tied up at two. And Sioux College is saying that the Sioux College goaltender Tarantini is saying that it went off a stick. But from this angle, we couldn't tell if it went off a stick or not. We could just tell it fell in the back of the net. So we'll have to see what they decide as all four officials are talking about it. Hard to believe the two standing at the blue line could tell if it went off something or not. But the referee standing in the goal line should be making that call right away. Back on January 20th, in Davenport, the Sioux College Cougars defeated the Panthers by a score of 8-2. And the ruling is, that was puck was hit by a high stick, and therefore no goal. So with 2 minutes and 11 seconds left to go, the Sioux College Cougars are up by a score of 2-1. It took a few seconds to make that decision, but obviously it must have went off a high stick somewhere. And the score is Sioux College 2, and the Panthers 1. The faceoff will come outside the line. Sterin and Jameis on the draw. Jameis winning that draw. Back to Nate Jordan Ritchie. Long pass, looking for Jameis coming in. Pass back, shoot, scores! Michael Chaffee. What a play that was on a long pass, and Jameis found Michael Chaffee coming in, picking up the rebound. And it's 3-1 for Sioux College. Long pass by Jordan Ritchie. Jameis found Michael Chaffee coming in late, and he buried it in the open net. What a play that was. Hartline checked by Chaffee, looking for another one. Chaffee shooting, and Bartel was right there. And Michael Chaffee, just 8 seconds later, was looking for his second of the game. 1:52 left to go in period number two. Sioux College 3, and the Panthers 1. Jameis and Healy on the draw to the left of Austin Bartel. And Healy winning that draw, but Chaffee coming in. That's going to be kept in by Johnson. Johnston, Esposito into Jameis. Jameis still has the puck. Far net! Esposito with a glorious chance from 4 feet in front of the net, but he couldn't beat Bartel. Back comes Hartline. Over the line, one-on-one with Johnson. Hartline, and a good play by Johnson to stop that threat. Nick Ritchie, beautiful setup, he just had a point. Ethan Esposito for Ritchie in front of that, and it was knocked away at the last second by Lichick. Ryan Long, check that, that's Gambler, Ryan Gambler, coming in. Chaffee, good shift for number 72. Jameis, shoot short side, that was blocked. Back to Johnson, looking for Chaffee in front of that, turn shot, rebound! Oh, and what a save that was! That might have been blocked by Lichick. Chaffee to Jameis. Far side. Looking for Johnson coming in. In front of the net. And finally it's on the stick of Nathan Hartline. And that one off the skate of Brian Wolk. All the way down. Nick Ritchie. All pass. And that one off the stick of Santa Maria. And Caleb Wood will fire it in. Bartel will leave it there for Zach Snyder. Snyder will turn and go the other way. Olenzik on the left side. Ritchie, pass to Caleb Wood. Here comes Caleb Wood, the captain of the Cougars. Number 19, shoots! And that one off a stick high over the top of the glass and into the netting. 7.1 seconds to go in period number two. Sioux College 3 and the Davenport Panthers 1. One last chance for the Sioux College Cougars to increase the lead before the end of the second period. Santa Maria on the draw. And there it is, right off the draw. Caleb Wood with a shot wide. But they're saying they didn't do it fair. And they should be putting time back on the clock. But they're not. It's 5.7 seconds now. Jock. Perry with a shot. And that scores! Mateo Perry with a shot right off the draw. And you can't get much closer than that. 1.1 seconds left to go. And Mateo Perry on the back of the goal. That is 4-1 for Sioux College. And those goals late in the period, they hurt. And something happened here off the faceoff. That's the second time in a row that the linesman didn't drop it right. But they're going to let the time run out. And after 40 minutes of play, the Sioux College Cougars lead the Davenport Panthers by a score of 4-1. We'll be back in about 13 minutes time for the third period. As we look at the scoring recap of the second period, there was three goals scored, all by the Sioux College Cougars. Ethan Novello at the 7:46 mark made it 2-0 for Sioux College. And then at the 2-minute mark, Michael Chaffee made it 3-1. And at the 1.1 second mark, number 13, Mateo Perry made it 4-1. My apologies for the Sioux College Cougars. Here we go, period number three is underway. Jackson Jocks has the puck to Jordan Ritchie. Jordan Ritchie up the center, off the skate of Jameis. Jameis, Barnett, Chaffee. That was bouncing around. Jackson Jocks keeps it in. And that's Lichick on the puck side. Lichick shot in front of his own net. And there was no damage. Chaffee's going to give it back to Ritchie. Shot that one just wide of the goal. Long. And it squirts out. And that's going to be Hartline. And Hartline backhanded the puck into his own bench. With 19:25 left to go in period number three, Sioux College 4, and the Davenport Panthers 1. Arian Starin, the captain of the Davenport Panthers, on the draw. Nick Jameis for the Sioux College Cougars on the draw. Back to Jock. Quick shot there by Ritchie. Rebound. Chaffee to Jameis. And he shot that one 20 feet wide. Back comes the Davenport Panthers. And that was real close to too many players on the ice. Jackson Jocks intercepted that pass coming through center. Jock shoots right on. And that puck stuck to the belly of Austin Bartel. 19:03 left to go in period number three. Sioux College 4. And the Davenport Panthers 1. Santa Maria winning that draw. And the puck comes back on the stick of Zach Snyder. Snyder to Olenzik. Gabe Olenzik. Intercepted by Taguna. Santa Maria across to Johnson. That's Taguna down the left side. Taguna keeping the puck around the far side. Back to Bly. Bly shoots, and that one found its way in and went wide of the goal. Race Jacobs out to Olenzik. Olenzik that bounced off Santa Maria. And Taguna hands it off to Bly. Bly down the right side over the line. Bly coming right in, but he decides to go around the goal. And he stops. He was crunched there by two players from the Davenport Panthers. Caleb Wood looking for a puck to squirt out. And there it is. But Wood can't find it. To Hartline down the left wing. Hartline in front of the goal. And that was swung. And Wolf didn't get much on that one. Taguna was hammered in the boards. And here we go. We got a little get together in the far side. As Taguna was pounded into the boards. And a little pushing and shoving going on. That's Chase Johnson over there with Brian Wolk. And Santa Maria and Hartline saying good afternoon. And they'll both sit in the box. And we'll see what the penalties are if an extra penalty goes to the Davenport Panthers. .17:44 left to go in period number three. And this is the first little bit of hostility that we've seen so far in tonight's game. Back on January 20th, Caleb Wood and Nathan Esposito led the way to an 8-2 victory for the Sioux College Cougars as they played in Davenport. Since Christmas, the Sioux College Cougars have had a record of six wins and two losses. They've been on fire so far since the Christmas break, and they look to add to that 6-2 record here in the final game of the regular season. There's two Davenport players sitting in the box with the door still open. So now there's three sitting in the box, and we'll have to wait and see what the penalties are. And the referees are over to explaining to the coaching staff of the Davenport Panthers what's going on. There's two Sioux College Cougars in the box and three Davenport Panthers in the box. And we'll wait for the public address announcer to tell us what the penalties are. Face off to the right of the Davenport Panthers goaltender, Austin Bartel. And so we're going to play 5-on-4 hockey after all said and done. Sioux College Cougars will have 5 on the ice, and the Davenport Panthers will have 4 on the ice. Here we go. Jameis and Olenzik on the draw. Jameis winning that chuck puck back. Jackson Jock to Ethan Esposito. Esposito to Jameis, and that was deflected out into the neutral zone. Good active stick by number 21, Luke Nicholas. Esposito to Windsor. Windsor over there. He dumps it in. Windsor coming, being there first. Over to Ethan Esposito. And he's tied up on the boards by Nicholas. But Chaffee has the puck. Chaffee has a goal so far for Sioux College tonight. So does Jameis. Back to Jock. Jock over to Ethan Esposito. Back to Jock. Jameis shoots. Scores! What a pass that was! On a backdoor play by Nick Jameis on the tape of Ethan Esposito. And it's 5-1 for the Sioux College Cougars. A power play goal by number 9, Ethan Esposito. His second of the game. And that puck was just chopped, nine iron style, into the bench of the Davenport Panthers. 16:52 left to go in period number 3. Sioux College 5, and the Davenport Panthers 1. Bartlett and Windsor on the draw. Windsor winning that cleanly. Back to Crowder. Crowder shoots. That one was steered aside by Bartel. Olenzik up through center, and that puck is dumped inside the Sioux College zone. Mateo Perry playing his final home game as a Sioux College Cougar. Oh, that was up the middle. That's a no-no. Shoot, Sarantini would steer that aside. And how many times do you see those cross-ice passes in your own zone end up in your own net? Back comes the Sioux College Cougars. Windsor was hit in behind the goal. Long. Still has it. And that in comes Zimbabwe. Windsor took a run at Long. And on the far side, Schneider steps away from Windsor. Long. That went off the skate of Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is going to give it back to Mateo Perry. Quickly up to Finitari. And he just dumps it in. Ian Milton gives it to Lichick. Coming through center, dangerous play by Olenzik, but he got away with that one. Olenzik on the tape of Race Jacobs, who got tied up with LaValle, and LaValle fell down. Crowder, big Cole Crowder, got the puck out, and it comes back in quickly. So Crowder will try again. Cole Crowder, number 27 for the Sioux College Cougars. Russ Oldham, clipped it high out, and Lavallee tried a volleyball headbutt on the puck, but missed. Back comes the Panthers, number 25, and that's Reese Jacobs. That's a high stick as Jacobs knocked the puck out of the air with a stick. Oh, and there's a shot there to the face of Riley Lavallee, and that should be good for at least a double minor. No hostility here in period number three. We couldn't tell from here whether Lavallee said something or not. But Race Jacobs didn't like what was going on, and he just give it to the Sioux College player, Roddy Lavallee. And it looked like Russ Oldham's going in the box, so something happened. We got more penalties on the play. .15:05 left to go in period number three. And we've got more penalties. The Sioux College Cougars 5 and the Davenport Panthers 1. Discussion by the referees at the center ice to see what exactly the call is going to be. And let's just hope that Riley Lavallee is okay, as he took a high hard shot from the stick of Race Jacobs. And there's no penalties on the board, so is it 2 minutes each? We don't know. We'll have to wait for the official announcements. And it's going to be 4-on-4 hockey. So that's what it looks like it's going to be, 2-2. Braden Bartlett and Nick Jamis on the draw just outside the Sioux Greyhound line. As we take a look at Zach Tarantini, the goalie, the senior goaltender of the Sioux College Cougars, playing his final home game. Congratulations to Zach, and it looks like he's well on his way to a win here at home. Congratulations to his mom and dad on a well-rounded young man Zach has become. Back underway, and the Panthers have the puck, and that's dumped inside the Sioux College zone. Nick Ritchie gathering it in. Here comes the smooth skating defender on the stick of Nick Jamis. Number 22 down the right side decides to stop, button hooks. Back to Kipling, shoots, deflected, scores! Nick Ritchie on a deflection in front of the goal. And it's 6-0, 6-1 for the Sioux College Cougars. Kipling took the shot, and Ritchie found it in the air, and used his baseball skills, and knocked it out of the air, in behind Austin Bartlett. And it's 6-1 with 14:40 left to go in period number three. Ritchie setting it up behind his own goal. Jamis coming through the center ice, and he takes the puck. Jamis coming through center. Around the far side, Jamis going to be right in. For a goal, and he maybe should have shot that one. Ritchie to Jamis. Drops it off to Ritchie. Final goal deflected in front of the net by Kipling, as they were trying to go the other way. Ritchie shot, and Kipling with a deflection. But that one didn't work. Back come the Panthers. Staring. And that's Nicholas. Back to Sterbass, picked off by Jamis. ahead. Kipling has a break all by himself. Right in, oh, and he fired it over top of the net. He was all by himself, and he fired it over top of the goal. Back comes Sterin. Across to Nicklaus. Sterin coming in. Sterin, oh, what a right time save that was by Tarantini as he saved another goal. Beauty. His best of the game. His best in a long time for Tarantini as he gets congratulations from his teammates by big number 31. 13:39 left to go in period number 3. Sioux College 6 and the Davenport Panthers 1. Bartlett winning that draw. Back to Lichick. Lichick just backhands it back inside the Sioux College zone. Bly in behind the goal. And Jocks come in and take up a loose puck. Chaffee. Long pass. On the break. Oh, and Caleb Wood had a bounce over top of the stick as he was gone. Caleb Wood has the puck. Looking for Chaffee, but Chaffee didn't see it. Lichick. And Woods coming out with the puck. No, Chaffee decides to keep it. Back to Jock. Jock back to Chaffee. Chaffee into Caleb Wood. Shoot, scores! Caleb Wood with a short side shot. And that beat Austin Bartel low on the glove side. And it's 7-0 for the Sioux College Cougars. We had a good game here, a close game until the third period. We had a little bit of extracurricular activities going on. And now some goals as Sioux College is pulling away. Keystone Bly has the puck for Sioux College. Jackson Jock coming out, flipping it high in the air, out into the center ice area. Hartline on the far side. And Bly gathers it in. Flips it out to Caleb Wood. He lets it go for Santa Maria. Here comes Aaron Sterin. Arian Sterin, the captain of the Davenport Panthers. Ryan Gamber coming through his own zone, slaloming through the center ice area. Over the line, stopping Gamber. He was checked by Wood, and Wood's got a breakaway. Caleb Wood all by himself. Wood, and he made too many moves as Caleb Wood maybe had too much time to think. Oh, and that was Santa Maria, and there was a pass. And how did Caleb Wood miss that one? He had an open cage. And maybe I could have scored on that one. Caleb Wood will be thinking about that one tonight. Holy cow, we have an open net. Look at him. He's thinking about it already, heading back to the bench. Caleb Wood, he's probably smiling underneath the visor. But he's probably a little bit mad too. He should have had that one. And he knows it. 11:50 left to go in period number 3. Sioux College 7 and Davenport 1. Russell them on the draw for the Sioux College Cougars, and he wins that back to Crowder. Crowder back to Novello. Novello shot it to an open corner. Perry come in, oh, and he was looking for Novello in front of the goal, but he couldn't find contact with the puck. Hartline lost it. Russ Oldham to LaValle. LaValle, couple of nice moves there, and Oldham comes out with the puck on the far side to Perry. Perry just dumps it in, and Novello will chase it down. Novello on the far side, Hartline. That's going to be picked up by Novello. Third goal! Oh, and LaValle with a shot and a nice save by Bartel. He come out to challenge on that one. Snyder couldn't get it by Crowder. And it's on the far side. And the referee has his arm up. There's going to be a penalty to somebody. And somebody's going to get the gate for cross-checking, and we'll see who it is. And it looks like Russell Oldham, the guilty party. And he's going to sit in the box for 2 minutes or less. And the Davenport Panthers will go back to the power play with 10:57 left to go in period number 3. Sioux College 7 and Davenport 1. And Davenport has used their 30-second timeout. Ethan Esposito leads the Sioux College Cougars with 38 goals and 24 points, and that's 24 assists, and that's good for 62 points. Not far behind, Jameis has 54 points. Michael Chaffee is third on the team with 46 points. Arian Sterin leads the Panthers with 31 points. And if it's, they're going to have a chance to narrow the gap, Arian Sterin is going to have to come up with some offensive abilities. And the faceoff will come to the right of the Sioux College goaltender, Zach Tarantini. Healy, Hartline, and Gamber up front for Davenport. Nicholas and Sterin on the point on the power play. Holy cow, where a puck go there. And Sterin has to come back and get the puck inside his own zone. He drops that off for Luke Nicholas. Healy intercepted by Windsor. And there's going to be a break. Right in. Oh, there it was. And he went left to right. And Zimbardo was stopped. Windsor trying to come back around. And he couldn't find the handle of the puck. Two huge chances for Sioux College in to increase their lead. Zimbardo causing all kinds of trouble back there. Windsor. And he decided, but he gave that away. He wanted to shoot it back to Windsor. And that puck was deflected out inside into the neutral zone. Zach Snyder for the Panthers. Around Chaffee. And Nick Jordan Ritchie trying to get it out. That went off a high stick. And they didn't call that one. That was more of a high stick than the goal they called back. Sterin with the puck for Davenport to Will Healy. And that's Jacobs back on the ice after he gave LaValle the business. Taguna bothering Sterin, and Sterin needs a change. Snyder stops and stops in behind his own goal. Zach Snyder on the stick of Bartlett to Lichick. He was checked by Chaffee. 20 seconds left to go in the penalty to the Sioux College Cougars. And Chaffee rips one off the boards. Almost went into the bench. Back comes Zach Snyder. Down the left wing by Jock. And Crowder will get it up to Finitieri. That was out of his reach. And the penalty's up. And Oldham's out of the box. Crowder coming in. Oh, there was a knee attempt. They could have called that one as that player stuck his knee out at Cole Crowder. Back comes Olenzik. Olenzik giving it off to Jock. Jackson Jock trying to go through the five hole. There was a shot by Esposito, a quick one. And Bartel knocked it aside. Esposito has a couple goals tonight for his efforts in his final home game. In his final home game of the year. Jameis chasing the puck down behind the net. Esposito back to Crowder. That pass was stopped by Sterin. Esposito turning with the puck, stopping at the line. Esposito across to Crowder. And Sterin picks it up. Down the right wing, Finitieri chasing him down. And Tarantini will give it off there to Jackson Jock. Coming out the right side, cutting to the center. Through center, over the line. Cutting in, shoots, and he shot that one just wide of the left goal post. Esposito fired it to an open corner. Jameis bothering Gamber in behind the goal. And Jock's keeping it in to Esposito. Esposito backhand pass in front of that. Finitieri back to Jock. Decides to shoot. Deflected in front of goal by Esposito as he was looking for his third of the night. And a nice deflection there by the low shot of Jackson Jock. 7:27 left to go in period number three. Sioux College 7 and the Davenport Panthers 1. Santa Maria winning that back to Wood. Walks in on! Oh, and he rifled a shot high over top of the net. And the puck's pushed ahead by Hartline, but he couldn't get through all the defenders. Caleb Wood, nice move there to get away from the defender. Caleb Wood, off to Mateo Perry, back to Caleb Wood, cutting through center, decides to drop it off to Bly, Easton Bly, to Wood, he was checked. Bly, coming in, shoots! And Bartel got his glove on that one. Back to Santa Maria. And that went through Taguna's legs. And out comes the Davenport Panthers. But Santa Maria will be there first. And he'll come back inside his own zone. And Taguna with a little bit of a shot there. And another one. As Luke Nicholas gave it back to him. Josh Nick Ritchie coming in, shooting it in. Wood on the near boards. And there's going to be a penalty. And the officials let two blatant ones go at the far end. And then they call another one against the Sioux College Cougars. 6:16 left to go in period number three. Sioux College 7 and Davenport 1. So Nick Ritchie will send the box for 2 minutes or less, and that will be cross-checking. Lenzik, long, and Wolk up front for Davenport on the power play. Windsor pounds one off the boards down the ice, and Bartel will leave it there for Ryan Gamber. Gamber gives it to Zach Snyder. Snyder coming down the right wing, cutting to the center. And he lost control of the puck. Windsor was knocked down from behind. No call. And the puck comes out over the line. So the Bat Panthers have to vacate the zone. Lenzik shoots. And he shot that one high off the glass. Gamber. Across to Snyder. Shoots right on. And that puck ends up in the glove of Zach Tarantini. 5:33 left to go in period number three. 1:17 left to go in the penalty to Jordan Ritchie. Sioux College 7 and Davenport 1. Healy on the draw, and he just about won that one, but it comes back down the ice, and Arian Stern comes back inside his own zone. Sterren, chased by Chaffee, decides to give it back to Nicholas on the near side, Hartline. And Hartline's been their best player today's game so far. And a good play by Kipling to chip it down the ice. And Sterren will have the puck on the far boards. And that's Nicholas. Back to Sterren on the near side. Coming down the left side, that's dumped inside the Sioux College zone. Kipling will be there, and he'll fire it back down the ice. Right on, and Bartel will pass it up to Nathan Hartline. Big number 17, Nathan Hartline. Up to Sterren. Sterren stops. Nice move by Wood. It was a drive-by there by Wood. And the puck's dumped down the ice. 15 seconds left to go in the penalty. Connect to Jordan Ritchie. And Matthew Lychik, has the puck. Oh, and that was close to being a shot on goal by Lychik. And Snyder coming out on the far side. The penalty's now over. And the Sioux College Cougars are back to full strength. And there's a linesman down just in front of the Sioux College bench. But didn't see what happened to him. But he's up, and he looks to be okay. Even the people out there in the striped shirts are prone to getting knocked around a little bit. 4:10 left to go in period number three. Sioux College 7 and Davenport 1. Wolk and Jameis on the draw. Jameis winning that draw. but won't get there, got there first. And that's going to be Bly coming out, handing it off to Esposito. Back to Bly. Bly, third for Esposito, scores! That's his third of the night. We'll see if any hats make it on the ice as Ethan Esposito makes it 8-0 for the Sioux College Cougars. With 3:57 left to go in period number three, Ethan Esposito has three goals for the Sioux College Cougars. Jackson Jock with the puck across and back to Jock. That was out of the reach of Jameis, and that's going to be icing on the Sioux College Cougars. If I can recall, that might be the first icing on the Sioux College Cougars in the entire game. So the faceoff will come back to the left of Zach Starantini. 3:45 left to go in period number three. Sioux College well in control, up by 7. Jameis winning that draw. Looking for Bly. Oh, as he looked for the puck, he couldn't find the puck. And Schneider made a nice play. That's going to be offside as Jameis had a break. But Bly was stuck inside the zone. Back come the Davenport Panthers. That's Gamber. He shot that one in. And Johnson will be there first to get the puck. Jackson Jock. That was behind Bly. He's Esposito. He couldn't get anywhere. Back comes Hartline, one-on-one with Johnson. Hartline with a nice move. Hartline scoring right in. And there might be a penalty shot on this. Let's see what it'll be. Because Hartline was all by himself. And he was hooked from behind. So we'll see what they call. And they have to talk about this again. And the call will be hooking on the Sioux College player. Very close to a penalty shot as Hartline was all by himself. And Jock got a piece of him with a stick, stopping a golden scoring opportunity. So with 3:08 left to go in the period number three, Davenport will go back to the power play. And the faceoff will come to the right of Zach Tarantini. Quickly off the draw, Cole Crowder pounds it down the ice. And Bartel will leave it there for Zach Snyder. Race Jacobs coming in and he's curling. But Snyder decides to go himself. Hands it off to Gable Enzik. Across to Wolk. The far side shoots. That one went all the way across the crease. Kipling's trying to be there first. And he got it out down the ice. And Race Jacobs will be back to pick it up for the Panthers. Leaving it there for Snyder. Snyder coming down the left side. And Crowder easily stopped that one. Windsor's going to knock it down the ice. Nice work by number 5 for the Sioux College Cougars. Bartel will hand it off to Matthew Lichick. Lichick will leave it there for Hartline as Lichick needs a change. Starin turns and will reset in behind his own goal. 120 seconds left to go in period number three. Out come Davenport behind Starin. That might be icing. No icing on the play. Cole Crowder. He fired that one high off the glass and down the ice. And Bartel passes it up to Nicholas. He'll give it back to Starin. In behind his own goal. Starin bounces that back to Nicholas on the far, on the near boards. That went by Perry. Perry has the puck in behind the goal. Fires that one off the glass, and that's going to come out into the neutral zone. 10 seconds left to go. In the penalty to Jackson Jock. Starin up the center to Hartline. And Hartline with a weak shot there, trying to get it in deep. And Crowder has it. Crowder up to Bly. Bly was poke checked right at the line by Ryan Gamber. We're under a minute to go in the third period. Sioux College up by 7. White Lichick on the near boards. He was tripped by Jameis. Jameis, but it has to Bly that jumped over his stick. Bly took his man into the boards. Lichick slowly coming out of his own zone, and that was just out into the neutral zone. Will Healy down the right side. Stopped by Windsor. Another shot there, and that one went wide of the goal. Healy hit there by Bly. Shoot there by Gamber, and Gamber shot that one high over top of the goal. Mateo Perry, one last rush for the senior, playing his last home game as a Sioux College Cougar, number 13. And the puck shot down the ice. No icing as Tarantini plays it. And let's let the crowd bring the last home game home. And there's the buzzer. Final game of the year for the Sioux College Cougars at the Northern Community Center. A final score, the Sioux College Cougars 8 and the Davenport Panthers 1. 1-1 after the first period of play, but after that, it was all Sioux College. Ethan Esposito leading the way for the Sioux College Cougars as he had 3 goals. And a good way to end the regular season for the Sioux College Cougars. And good luck to both the men and the women's teams as they head off to their regional playdowns. Once again, the final score here at the Northern Community Center, the Sioux College Cougars 8 and the Davenport Panthers 1. For the entire Sioux College Cougars hockey team, my name is Mike Armitage. Thanks very much for watching, and good afternoon from Sault Ste. Marie.